And then finally will come the sound of the self, the Atma. And that is indescribable. There immediately you will have such a joy, ananda, that no any worldly desires can give you that feelings. Consciousness that we call the Shiva. Shiva means consciousness, Shiva means liberation. Shiva means happiness, Shiva means beauty, and Shiva means the bliss. So liberation, the liberation is in the consciousness itself is a liberation. Consciousness itself is liberated already. But the Shakti about which we are more aware is dormanted down Kundalini. Now some people then are talking about Shiva and Shakti like a male and female bodies. This is a commercial part of this subject. So in male there is also Shakti, and in female there is also Shakti. In the female is also Shakti and the consciousness, though both are together. And this is an entire universe. It is so Shakti as well as consciousness has no form. So there is no anatomical differences, and there is all equality, all are the same, and everyone they can achieve this consciousness, that level. Now, in the Muladhar Chakra here in this body, here is, this is lowest part of the chakra, which we yesterday spoke. There's Earth Chakra, we are on the, till from the footsole till the ankle joints, then vegetation chakra, they are from the ankle joints till the knee, then animal chakra from knee till the hip joints. And the human chakra is from the hip joints till the throat. And the divine chakra, where the jnanendriyas are located, is this called the divine chakras. And there is a seat of the consciousness, seat of the intellect, seat of the bliss, and so on. And down here is the seat of the our presence consciousness, where we are stuck. The development of the human consciousness takes place from the Muladhar Chakra. So our Shakti at present is here, and here is dormanted our destiny, all our deeds from past lives. This is the Shiva Lingam. Shiva means the consciousness, Linga means the universal body. The Linga is the consciousness. So your consciousness is the Linga. The Shiva, Linga is the attribute, just the Shiva attribute. And this is a Shakti, a snake, coiled three times. Three and half. Actually, she should look down. It coiled three times, then power is going down. Here is the border between human and animal consciousness. And so, though human consciousness is higher, but the tendency is going down. But in our Kundalini book, I put it up as a motivation for you, it's going up. Three coiled means past, present and future. Your destiny is influencing your life for the past and present and the future. And this is three, therefore it's called three times. It's called Bhutkal, Vartman and Bhavishya. Past, present and future. Life from the past, present life and future life. The action from the past, present and future. The reaction from the past and present and the future. And three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas. So this three number, it has many, many meanings in it. So through practicing elephant, beautiful elephant, nice, he's a very nice one, little, but he could be also more dangerous than crocodile, you know. From crocodile you can run quickly away, but from this is... Elephant, in Hindu mythology, elephant means happiness or wisdom again. And if you see the elephant, then it's like a wisdom or like a Ganesha, the remover of the obstacles. Seven trunk he got. And I am born in India, I saw many elephants, but till today I didn't see even with the two trunks. But ask me then, why did I put the seven trunks? From where did it came? That is in your body, what should I do? These seven trunks, because this is earth element, earth chakra, and seven trunks means the seven minerals, Shapta Dhatu. And if you know the Ayurveda, what means the Sapta Dhatu and how important is the Sapta Dhatus in our body. The seven minerals, which is very important in our body for our good health. So this is balancing health. So in Ayurveda, the first thing, first mantra, first is say, Pehla Sukh Nirogi Kaya. Pehla Sukh Nirogi Kaya. The first happiness is healthy body. Sukha cannot be translated in English language. You have no any word about that. So you can only say happiness or pleasureness or the comfortable or something like this. Or good life. So pehla sukha nirogi kaya. If you are healthy, then you are the richest person in the world. And if you are unhealthy and you have millions of your dollars, you can't eat. And the doctor tells you, don't eat more than one bread. So you can't eat your dollars. And if you are healthy, active, you eat what you want and you enjoy your life and swim and run and everything very good. Health is the... So first wealth is good health. Pehla sukh nirogi kaya. First wealth is good health. And so this... Sapta Dhatu, seven minerals for our physical, mental and spiritual health is very important. And Shiva is now here Pashupati Mahadev. In Nepal there is a Shiva temple called Pashupati Mahadev. The Shiva is a lord of the animals as well as the humans, and he's a lord of the entire creatures. So from here the human consciousness begins to develop and going up. And then we are in Svadhishthana Chakra. We are talking today now about Svadhishthana Chakra. Many know about orange color, many don't know, so I just explain you. Orange color is a color of renunciation. Color of the renunciation. Now is autumn, and you see all your trees have this orange color. The leaves will fall down. It will renounce. The nature is renouncing. Therefore, the Swamis, the monks have the orange color. This is, means that he or she has renounced everything. Then is the color of the dawn, when the sun rises. And when the dawn rises, then entire nature awakes. So this is a color of the awakening of the consciousness. And when the sun sets, then it's again orange color like this. And all entire nature renounce, withdraws back. So this color is a change of the consciousness. Development in the consciousness. Uthan. And this is a color of the earth, and therefore it is a thou art salt of the earth. We are born, this body is from this earth, and it will merge again into the earth. This orange color is a color of the fire, and fire means purification. Everything will be purified through the fire. Whatever you put in the fire, fire will burn everything and purify. When you put the newspaper and mistakenly you put $1 million dollars in the fire, fire will not tell you, hey guy, take care, there's dollars inside, take it out. Fire will not say it. This is his principle. His principle is to purify everything. And of course, Australian dollar goes quicker because they are plastic, you know. So, but don't burn that, please. Because not because of the dollars, but the pollution, plastic. And that's why, sorry, the Krishna also have this color, the fire color, because Vishnu means the Agni. Vishnu means the fire, the purification, and renunciation. And so, this color is also very safety now in this modern civilization. When you walk on the street, every driver knows the Swamiji is walking. Even if the driver is drunken, suddenly we know, by God, some orange person is moving. So it's a very safety color. And then for the sake of spirituality, and there are sometimes people believe that there is some negative energy, some magic and like this, that someone can do with you something from far distance. So through this color, through this fire, no any negative energy can go through. No one can practice on you any black magics. You are safety, bulletproof. That's, this color is bulletproof. And that's why this color. Another meaning of this color, we spoke very in beginning, that Muladhara was a red, solid energy, Shakti. This red rose, is it rose or lotus rose? Red rose, this is a solid color called a Shakti. Again, mother, feminist. And when this solid Shakti begins to awake, then it becomes orange color. And so, it is a symbol of the awakening. The Shakti now begins to function. But there is sitting crocodile. And crocodile is some symbolizing a lazy. So laziness comes, tamas guna. Crocodile means anger. And crocodile is very dangerous. So you can come from Muladhara up, but there is sitting enemy which not let you go through. So it is said to live in the water and have an enemy with crocodile is not advisable. Now we have to go through this. So this is a symbol because the crocodile energy, the crocodile is this, and that we have in the Svadhishthana Chakra, we will speak then after. The half moon, the crescent moon, this half moon is a symbol of the awakening or beginning. Like a new moon, the crescent moon comes from that day. By day, the moon is becoming growing, and after 14 days, the moon becomes full moon. Similarly, day by day, practicing, your consciousness will rise and come to the completeness, to the fulfillment, or to the supreme, the self-realization or the God-realization. Moon means also emotion. And the waves, high waves and low waves, and this all differences in your ocean, which is movement, is depending on the moon. It is moon who is bringing the emotion. And moon is a principle of the mind. And mind is never equal. Similarly, moon is never equally rising every day. It's different. Either increasing or decreasing. So here moon means increasing and decreasing means we are changing our feelings as well as we are changing our thoughts. I change my mind, I change my mind. And it is an emotion and it is connected to the emotional centers in our body, which is a passion. The sexual diseases are the desires, and Where the sexual desire is strong, then there is a strong jealous. And when there is a jealous, why jealousy is coming? Because you think someone will take away. A small child, when some toys takes away, then child will be jealous because someone will take my jealous away, or my toy. Jealousy is there where you can't do something against. If you can do against, then you need not to be jealous, you just give on the face. But you know that other, when you kick on a little bit, the other one will kick, all teeth will fall out. That's it. Therefore, you can't do anything, but innerly you are suffering. Jealous. Where the jealous, there's a hate. And when the hate and jealous comes together, becomes a big anger. And anger is again fire which will destroy everything. And when the anger is there but you can't do anything still, then other develops quality called the revenge. Now your blood is boiling in the fire of the revenge. And when the chance comes and you want to take a revenge, then you go above your all limits and one becomes cruel, the cruelty. So the jealous is causing anger, cruelty, revenge, and also the greediness. These are the six negative qualities or a hindrance on our spiritual development which we should master. The modern psychology said jealous is a sign of undeveloped personality. That person is not completely developed. When you are completely developed, then you are not jealous because you can live without this also. So, but I'm sure you are not anyone, so I don't talk more about this. So these are the six petals. So you can say the jala passion, here is the desire. And from here, from this kama, then comes kam, krodha, lobha, moha, ahamkaras, and revenge, I have forgotten in Hindi. But is there somebody Hindi speaking? Revenge. No. Pratishod and Agni, the fire. So these are the six petals and this is constantly moving. Now you have to go under this. This is, and that's why the crocodile have little mouth opened. Be careful, okay? It doesn't take time him to open quickly. And so this is the symbol. Then there's a mantra. Is called Bija Mantra. Mantra here means resonance of that chakras. This is a vam. The sound, Nada Rupa Parabrahma. Yesterday we spoke, the form of the Supreme is the sound, the Nada. And in entire body there is a different kind of sounds. When you meditate in according to the Nada Yoga, you close your ears and you listen the inner sound. There will be coming different 9 sounds. The 10th one is called the soham, the sound of the self, the realization. At the present, when you close your ears, you will hear only the waterfall. That is a blood circulation. That's all. So I tell you that don't think, oh, I awakened my sound. So please, can you plug your ears and listen for a while? So what you heard, like a waterfall, or like a train is going, or the sound of the ocean, the waves, this is a blood circulation. Now the second trial, we will do like this, chant Om and then long through the nose, the nozzle. Om. humming sound. So now close your ears. That's it. And listen inner sound. Chant Om. Om. Now this is the different sound than the waterfall. So likewise, now these were the two sounds. Now you will continue practice and there will develop different nine sounds. And these nine sounds, the eight sounds which are the chakras, and then finally will come the sound of the self, the Atma. And that is indescribable. There immediately you will have such a joy, ananda, that no any worldly desires can give you that feelings and that happiness, that joy, and so on. That's part of the Nada Yoga. Perhaps we will speak more about the Nada Yoga after. So these are the Bija Mantra. Bija means the seed. So the basic sound of this chakra resonance vibration is called Vam. And there are sub mantras on each petals. Now you see here two nice beautiful figures. According to the Hindu mythology, this is called Brahma. And the Brahma, which have the four head. Brahma is a creator. Brahma is the creator, Vishnu is the protector, and Shiva is the liberator. Beside the Brahma, his partner is the Saraswati. Saraswati is the goddess of the wisdom. What you learn, that knowledge is a Saraswati. And therefore in Indian every schools, there is an altar or a small temple of the goddess Saraswati, and in every school there is a prayer about Saraswati. All students. So Saraswati means then what you are learning. This learning capacity is a blessing of that is called Saraswati.